Today on BRStv, we have episode 12 of our Apex series, and we're going to go over the control light option in Apex Fusion. Hi, I'm Ryan, host of BRStv, where each week we cover a new topic related to reefing. This week, we're going to go over the control light option found in the control type dropdown when programming an outlet in the Apex Fusion cloud interface. Selecting the light option will preload a bunch of fields most people would commonly use for controlling any type of light. For this video, we'll focus on your primary lights for the aquarium. The first option is FallBack, and it's asking if the energy bar were to ever get disconnected from the Apex base unit, would you want the outlet to default to on or off? In this case, we want the light to default to off so we don't cook the corals if we were away for a few days and this were to happen. Next option is the on time. Select the time you want the light to come on. Depending on the type of tank and lighting, it's common for most people to maintain a lighting period between 8 and 12 hours. Most people who are closer to 12 have lights that are capable of gradually increasing throughout the day and dimming over the evening. They might also have multiple sets of lights where the halides are on for 8 hours, and some less intense lights like T5s are on for dusk and dawn. The daylight cycle also doesn't have to match the actual daytime at your house either. I suggest figuring out a schedule that matches your lifestyle so the lights are on when you're home. For the sake of this video, I'm just going to select 9 o'clock. The time is displayed on a 24-hour clock, so if I want to turn the lights off at 8 p.m., I'd enter 20. The next option is Shutdown Probe. This is a feature that's capable of turning off your lights based on the temperature of your tank. Lights can be one of the biggest sources of heat in the tank, so if your tank were to overheat because it was a hot day, your chiller failed, or someone turned off your home's AC, this could save the tank by turning off the lights. You could also set up an email alarm to notify you as well. Most of you only have one option, and it will say temp. I have a second option showing here because I have two temp probes on this tank. The one labeled X5 is attached to my PM2 salinity module and not the one they would use in this case. Select the one that says temp. Shutdown value is a temp where I want to turn off the lights. This is up to you, but most people will likely set it 1 to 2 degrees above where they want their tank to be. In this case, I'm going to set it to 80 degrees. If this is your first time programming a controller, hysteresis might be a somewhat foreign word to you, and certainly how it applies here. Basically, this is just how long you want to keep the lights off once the controller triggers a shutdown based on a high temp. If there wasn't a hysteresis option, the light would just keep turning off and on as the tank goes from 79.9 to 80 and then falls again. This would be pretty bad for the lights as well as pretty annoying visually. By default, it says 30 minutes, which means the lights will stay off for a minimum of 30 minutes, which makes much more sense. Hit the send to Apex and your light will be programmed moments later. The one thing you should note is this control interface is really just writing command lines for you. If you go back to the outlet, you can see the lines of code it wrote for you by hitting the advanced tab. If you'd like to do something a bit more advanced, like use the IO switch box to turn on or off lights based on a hard button, you could add some additional command lines here, something we'll come back to in the future. If you have questions or advice for your fellow reefers, check out the comments area down below. If this is your first time with us, hit that subscribe button because we do this every week. See you next week with another episode of BRStv.